Prasanna, so what is the way forward? Because the meeting is in 2 days' time. I mean, if this consensus is now brewing, do you see more and more boards? Because if I read the mail that you've sent out, it has now been sent to the ICC and each of the individual cricket boards. So what is the way forward for all of you?
What we want is that there should be a proper debate about this. It should not be steamrolled through the ICC. And I've specifically pulled out from Lord Wolfe's report the points on undue influence on cricket boards to try and, serve the agenda of certain people. I mean, these are things that Lord Wolfe had foreseen as possibly happening. So I think it's a wake-up call for the ICC and its members to say, hang on a minute, I think we need to look seriously at the report of Lord Wolfe and put this aside for a minute, and first let's get our governance right. Ultimately, it will be a decision made by the member boards. We can only be a pressure group. We can point out the failings. We have no vested interest. We act in the interest, we are there to protect the game. And the game is surely bigger than three people and three big egos.
But Asanbhai, what is interesting to me is Australia is one of the signatories, and you now have a former ICC president and a CEO from Australia voicing their concerns. That is pretty significant, and they need 7 out of 10 members to support the proposal to vote it through. And now it seems Pakistan, Australia, within Australia there's a problem. South Africa has already voiced its concerns. Clive Lloyd from the West Indies. So there is a consensus that's brewing against the big three. This is a first in world cricket in a while, I must say. Isn't that the case?
Yes, well, this sort of thing has never happened in world cricket, where so three people come along and want to take over the governing body of sport. I mean, this is totally unprecedented. It is a terrible move. If they had just stopped and thought about what they were trying to do, they would have not done it. I'm very, very disappointed at the, certainly at the Australian board chairman to have got involved in this matter. I'm not surprised about the other two gentlemen. Their records speak for themselves. But I think world cricket as a whole has to take responsibility for this. And I hope people will now stand up and start being counted.
You've just said very significant things. You've said the ECB president and the Indian board president, you are not surprised by these sort of proposals on their behalf, which is basically calling them dictatorial. You know, I'm not putting words into my mouth, but what you've written in that working paper is that the ICC president did not know about it. The ICC board of directors did not know about it. Have you had a chance to speak to any of them, or even the CEO, Dave Richardson?
No. I believe that I don't like to interfere in the workings of organizations of which I'm not a part. But I have pointed out my views. If they disagree with it, I'm sure they'll come out and say to me that I'm wrong. I don't believe I'm wrong. That's the whole point. So they know the truth. I know the truth. It's for them to now behave in an ethical way to deal with this problem.